magnificent men in the flying machine. They go up to the upper, they go down to the upper. They tackle the ladies and steal the scene.
You said this has five times the range of the other transmitters, right?
They say a mile on my outside.
We can solder back on. We don't really need it. It's our velocity thing.
Right there, the blue one and the black one.
Here's the.
Nice catch.
Yeah. You gonna go for another one?
Alright.
Okay.
The dream team.
You have to be careful. Here it. Get the right. The right.
There it goes.
What are the two?
But the issue we were having with all of our tailwheel designs is that we couldn't get enough control over it. The steering made it awful.
Like having a servo attached to it, it would like go straight, and if it turned a little bit and we tried to right it, it would go.
Oh, this thing wants to go.
Okay. One little piece of advice, if you hold it above you, even though it's a little further crash, you get a much smoother throw. So really straight arm, real easy.
Ready?
Ready? Go for it.
Oh my God!
Yes!
We'll call it like 10 seconds.
Lydia launches it, it's sort of going down,
and then it
suddenly
went up.
It comes back up.
That would be our pilot.
That was the first time this ever flew, right?
Yeah, that was the first
time. So that's pretty impressive.
The motor fell off. All we have to do is just redo the tail wing if we want it to be up and running again.
Assuming we didn't mess
anything
up.
Assuming all this is fine, but it should have been.
The battery pulled out both ends, so I think it's probably fine.
Oh my God.
So you feel you can take that to
a. And we have data, which is really awesome. So we can like see how high it was and like how the motors may have been like going faster to make it go up. Hopefully we'll see some sort of correlation there.
Yeah. Oh my God. This feels so good. Hours and hours and days and days paid off.
Yeah. Woo. Sorry, a little bit of a